Let's talk about functions and formulas. And if you stick by till the end, you're going to find out how to add only visible cells. But first of all, what is a function? What is a formula? What is the difference between the two? Because we hear a lot these two terms, function and formula. Basically, a formula is everything that comes after the equal sign. So if I write equal 1, this is a formula. You can write 1 plus, let's say, b1. And I can also put here sum of something, you know, sum of column C. I know this is a very stupid formula. It doesn't do anything, it will just equal 1. But it's a very simple example of what is a formula. Like, everything is a formula here. And the function is here. It's called sum. It's something that is predefined. For example, you probably know that the sum will add everything that is in these parentheses. So this is the difference between the two. I don't think I need to spend a lot of time in telling you how to put the plus or the minus or the slash or whatever between the, let's say, these elements, between the 1 and the b1 and so on. We have to remember to do that. But if I talk about syntax, I just want to point out that there are some rules that I need to respect if I'm using functions. For example, I'm writing the VLOOKUP function. It's very, let's say, it's a very well-known function, very important function in Google Sheets and also in Excel. And I can see that I can select it with the mouse or select it with the tab key. If I press tab, it will automatically select it. And I can see that I need to put the parentheses at the start, write a few things between these parentheses. In our case, it's about these four pieces of information that I need to write. So I need to put four. As a side note, ID started is optional. I can choose not to write it if I want to. How do I know that? Because it's in these square parentheses. I'm not sure how it's called this in English, like brackets or something. Okay, so what I need to know about functions when I'm writing them, to put the parentheses at the start, to respect the number of parameters that I'm required here, 3 at least, or maybe 4. Another example would be sumif, and I can also see that now I have 2 at the minimum and maybe the third one if I need it. So to respect the number of parameters and also to separate them properly using this semicolon or the comma, it depends on your spreadsheet settings what you need to put over there. Okay, I know theory, let's go into something more practical. Let's go into the data and calculate something. I want to calculate the total into another currency. I'm going to use lei because I know how to translate whatever. I assume that these are dollars into lei. So total RON will be something like this one divided by, I'm not sure how expensive leu is, something like around that, 4.3. I've written the formula. I just want to make sure that this is a number and not a date, because now it's not very clear. And I should have multiplied it if I want to translate it from a currency like dollars into lei, because that's how you do the transformation. So if I want to use simple formulas like that, like divisions, like multiplications, like whatever, it's pretty easy. Just click equal. I'm going to do it again. That one multiplied by 4.3. Now it's pretty easy. And then I'm going to want to multiply it, drag it down. And you can see that I can do that like that, or I can use the double click. You can see that there is a dot here, like a square dot. If I double click on that, it will go until the last row in the table, and it will show me the value as I calculated it. And now you're going to say, Radu, but the value of the currency exchange is very dynamic. It changes all the time. I want to be able to change it easily. And yes, you can. If I want to write this somewhere, maybe I write it in a cell right here. I want to write 4.3. I can also rewrite the formulas. I'm going to delete it to write it again. I can also write the formula in the following way. Equals that multiplied with that, you know, just click on the cells and click enter. I can see that if I double click, it will go into the onto the last row, but I have a problem. It says 0. Okay, why? because when I drag the formula down, it doesn't copy the exact formula, it adapts it to the new location. So in this case, I need to somehow lock this one in place. You know, I need to make sure that everything is multiplied by 4.3, and this is pretty easily because I can do it using the dollar sign. If you've seen the dollar sign in formulas in Google Sheets or Excel, that's the purpose, to lock in place a part of the formulas. Click enter, dragging it down, and I can see that the formula is working. Or I can also use the F4 key. For example, if I just select it and click F4, it will automatically put the dollars here and it will lock that part of the formula, so it doesn't change when I drag it down. Moving on, let's have a sum on this column, and I'm gonna go down here and also add a few rows, and I'm gonna create a sum here. If I'm writing equal sum, it automatically suggests what I need to write here, from J2 to J1001. This is pretty much what I want. I can use that suggestion, or I can write it by hand. It's pretty easy. You can see what the syntax is. If I want to say from until, you know, it's an interval, not two separate values. Enter. And I want to do something right now. You'll understand in a moment. What I want to do is to show you how this sum works when I also activate the filter. So yes, I have numbers here. I can see that it's a pretty large number on this column. And now I'm gonna filter on only the males, okay? And you can see that the value here does not take into account the filtering that is done above. Why? Because it uses sum, and sum does not do that. You know, just it doesn't do that. So if I want to create a sum that takes into account what I'm filtering, I'm gonna have to use something else, and clear the filter here. I'm gonna have to use subtotal, which is a separate kind of function, subtotal. And it says that I need to write a number here. And okay, maybe you say, Rad, what number should I write in function code? I have no idea. No problem, you can click learn more. And in the help section, you're gonna see that you need to write 9 for sum. So subtotal does also average, does also count or max or whatever. I'm interested in doing the sum, so I'm gonna write 9 over there. So besides that, I'm gonna close the help because it helped me enough. I'm gonna select the range. And to select the range, I just selected this cell, hit Control Shift up arrow, and then selected everything over there, enter, and you can see that the numbers are the same, are equal. But when I activate the filter, if I filter something like whatever, when I uncheck female, the number below, the subtotal, takes into account the filters and the filter, and the sum does not. Before you go, just wanted you to know that this video is part of a small online course, a free one. You can find links in the description below. And if you learn something new, hit the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to my channel. See you in the next one.